Don Morton. Don is a graduate of the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor. Sorry about that, Danny. After a successful career in music, he has transitioned into a career in financial services and is a chartered financial consultant. Don and his family moved to Roswell in 1986. He has served 8 years as president of the Club of North Point and is a member of the Roswell chapter of the Georgia Initiative for Community Housing, now known as the Roswell Initiative for Community Housing. Among his other associations, he's a member of the Kevin Executive Network and the Rotary Club of Roswell. He and his wife Dale have 2 children and 5 grandchildren. Don Morton, your statement.
Thank you, Hatcher, and Roswell Women's Club for sponsoring this forum, and to everybody that's here that's wanting to hear about this important election. You know, Roswell's a great place to live, but some on our council are on the wrong track about the kind of city the people of Roswell want to live in. They changed their zoning rules, and in the process, they jeopardized the very things that give Roswell its appeal. If we don't do something about it now, it may be too late by the next election. We are already making profound changes. For example, in the historic district, instead of 35% lot coverage that was in the old zoning code, now it reads up to 70% lot coverage through the new UDC. That's double what it was. Density was removed from the code. So now we're going from 1 or 2 homes per acre to 5 or 6 homes per acre, and in some cases, 7 to 10 homes. And we're doing this next to established neighborhoods. And I have to ask, why? Let me be clear. We need development, but our focus is wrong. We are neglecting blighted areas all over Roswell. And I say, let's redevelop. Today, 88% of the people who work in Roswell can't afford to live in Roswell. In fact, many of us have kids that can't afford to live here. But these new developments, they're all about $400,000 cottages, $600,000 townhouses, and instead we should be encouraging development that will create housing for the young professionals and young families that are the future of our city. But to do that, we need some new blood on City Council. You have a lot of choices for post 3, but I believe I'm the most qualified to deal with these issues. I have over 30 years experience in business and a decade of service to my community. I've worked on the Roswell Initiative for Community Housing. I've helped neighborhoods and developers come together and create good projects that have the support of the people. I know and understand zoning and development from both the public and the private sector point of view, and I want to bring business experience, not just government experience, into our city operations. Most important, if you elect me, I will represent your interest on these issues and not march in step with the good old boys at City Hall. Thank you again, and I look forward to answering your questions.
Thank you. Mr. Horton, 1 minute.
Thank you. I hope this forum has given you an idea about what each of us stands for. I believe I'm the best candidate for post 3 because my agenda is your agenda. I've been successful in business for over 30 years, and I understand the private sector as well as city government. I've served my community in everything from HOAs to arts to housing development, and I will serve the Roswell citizens because some of our city council aren't doing that very well. Most of you tell me you don't want to live in an urban center where the downtown buildings come right to the street and the houses are crammed together and there's little green space on city lots. You tell me you want to fix the blight and put higher density where it makes sense, not around our established neighborhoods. You say the city council needs to address traffic and infrastructure. And you tell me your government isn't listening to you. I think that means we need a change, and the time to make it is now. The mayor and some council members are pulling for one of my opponents because he's been part of their club for years. It's time for you to be heard, and if you honor me with your vote, I'll make sure someone listens to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.